We were taught to walk. We were taught to talk. We were taught to read. But were we taught to think, to create, to love, to hate? Topic inspired by summer of 2020, the year 2020. Again, it's a pretty warm day today here in Los Angeles. Feels like 88 degrees. I don't know, but it's warm, it's humid. And I see people with a face mask. I see the news where, you know, Trump knows that he can't, the latest headline is, Trump wants to postpone the elections. He knows very well that he can't, but he tweets about it to make everyone's butt cheeks clench. And then I think of people when I hear laughter, ha 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 ha, ha ha's. Or in America, what we call smoking and joking. And you don't want to hear smoking and joking when shit needs to get done. Alright, so I see we're finished. So we're fucking done. So it's a fucking joke. And, you guys wanna play games? You can play games. Look, there's so much going on that I'm gonna lose my thought process as usual. It's another video topic by itself. You know, where you needed, where you wanted, where can you help? No doubt there's some poor cunt right now, digging through a trash can, looking for the next meal, next source of food. There are idiots that are getting good at kicking the balls right now. Mortgage is not being paid, rent is past due. Unemployment is high. And so many other things. So when I hear this laughter, I think, you know, are things really that good? And I don't mean to be a party pooper and say, there's no laughter, no smiling. Beatings will continue until morale improves. No. But, you know, with so many victims, or so many of us being victimized right now, oppressed, what words? We're oppressed, you're eating my lunch. I'm drinking your milkshake. Is that what I am? There will be blood. I'll drink your milkshake. don't know, so many, again, people oppressed, racism, the imaginary problems, whereas real problems were, you know, there's drug addiction, suicide, homelessness, and things that lead up to homelessness. And the supposed Black Lives Matter, and you know that. And I think of that when I saw a homeless dude. I think about it even more when I saw a homeless dude sleeping on the sidewalk, and I forget, I know he had a hat on. I'm not sure if it was a beanie or a cap. He was black, and the shirt said Black Lives Matter. But, you know, it doesn't matter enough because he's still alive. And he's homeless. His wardrobe is just pretty much a blanket, some beat up shoes, some shoes that were talking, you know, where the soles are flying off, or, you know, almost worn off, look like tongues. And I'm pretty sure he probably, well, didn't check his pockets, but I could guess he probably has enough to go to the dollar menu, the value menu, value meals, value items at McDonald's or Jack in the Box, Burger King, or Hungry Jack's. Maybe he has enough to afford something. But most likely he'll probably go to a trash can, see what's there, or go by some restaurant and sit outside where some Black Lives Matter protesters. Quick note there, from where I saw this homeless dude on the street twice. There were Black Lives Matter protests right there in the area, and I thought, look, there's a black dude right there. Black Lives Matter or black homeless guys don't matter. Black Lives Matter, but only if they rob pregnant black women at gunpoint and pistol whip them, their buddies, like George Floyd, that piece of shit that got murdered. Yes, he was murdered, but he's still a piece of shit. I don't think I would have much empathy, sympathy, or any fucks given had that been my mom or my grandma or my sister or my girlfriend who was pregnant, who was to be robbed at gunpoint by this piece of shit, which he did. And that's why George Floyd went to prison for 5 years. And I just have all these stuff because, again, the newest racket is there are no coins. There are no coins. So you can't go to Chuck E. Cheese. You can't go to the arcades. You can't go drop stuff at a well. Remember someone wrote, you know, that's easy. Why don't they just drain all the money from the wells? Yeah, I saw some dude with his girlfriend or date or study partner, co-worker, I don't know, they were walking down the street. She doesn't have a mask on, but he does. I'm thinking, fuck, motherfucker. It's fucking warm today, what the fuck are you doing? I saw an Uber driver drop off three people with masks on. Older dude. Dude probably could have been my grandpa. At least my dad could have been my dad. Dad's age, grandfather's age, possibly my grandfather's age. And dropping off three people. I'm thinking, what the fuck is this old motherfucker here doing, working? Especially Uber. But we taught how to spend also. Time to think, to love, to create, to spend, to save. I think when I hear this song now, I feel more, I think, in the memory of more freedoms that we had, more choices. And no, I'm not going to this, oh man, I'm so oppressed. No, I'm not going into that fucking mode. But then I can't go to one of my favorite sandwich shops and sit down, enjoy their food, and enjoy the AC, and think. Because then I'm gonna kill, murder the whole zip code. Yeah, so I see all this fear. Also, Bill Clinton, more links, more stuff. I think link him and Prince Andrew, piece of shit Prince Andrew, to Jeffrey Epstein, and to his child raping island. Trump's about to possibly send in the National Guard to bring peace finally to Seattle, which is self-imploding, self-destroying, self-destructive. My phone died. Because I see so much fear. So many, I don't want to say problems, but it's obviously so many things that could be improved, upgraded, eliminated. What do you mean eliminated? You mean concentration camps? You know, if you eliminate the case of hepatitis A, C, tuberculosis, AIDS, or the newer cases of it, call me racist, but I think that'd be a good thing. You know, people are living in the fancy cities now, man. Most well-off of New York are leaving. Joe Rogan is leaving Los Angeles. Such is life, motherfuckers. Get after it.